In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make this really lovely donut motion animation right inside Canva. If you don't know me, I'm Jules, I'm your designer in your pocket, and please do keep following for more design tutorials and Canva tips.
I'm just going to break this down step by step from the very beginning and show you how I created this animation. So we start off with the blank page, and I'm going to go up and change the colour to the pale pink. And first of all, I'm going to add that grainy texture that you could see in there, and I did that by searching elements and just literally typing grainy texture. And into graphics, there is lots and lots of choices. And I think for quickness, I'm just going to choose one like this one. And I like this one because we can see from the color bar up here, I can change its color. And I'm just going to choose a slightly darker tone of the pink background so that it's not too in your face. And then what I'm going to do next is source the donuts. So I'm just again going to type in the search bar donut, and I'm looking for donuts that have that nice flat shape and four that are kind of similar style. So as you can see, there is lots of samples, and just quickly going to choose four that I think will work really nicely. Can click on magic recommendations, and then it gives you lots more examples that are a similar style. Now, once we've got the four donuts, I'm just going to bring them up here, and we really want to make them all the same size as each other. So I'm just going to place them on top, make them lovely, the same size. And the last one, here we go. Now what I want to do is draw just a plain circle, which we get from shapes, and I'm going to make it the dark purple that was in the original design, and then I'm going to move the layer of the circle to sit underneath the four donuts. And what we need to do now is to try and get the donuts to sit kind of exactly on top of one another, and I'm just going to use my guides to help me find the center point of the circle horizontally and vertically. And sometimes it helps if I just match that in the middle. Now at the moment the donuts are a little small, so I'm just going to select them all so that I can enlarge them all at the same time and keep them all the same size. And again, resize them, get them sitting nicely in the middle, like so. And I'm just kind of using my eye here, but we can roughly get them sitting nicely around that circle. Then what I'm going to go is, while we're still in our layers, I'm going to hold down the shift key on my keyboard so that I can select all the donuts and the circle at the same time. And then when I go back up to the top here, I can group them. And now as you can see, that's now just the one shape, and this makes it much easier to then do the motion animation. And what I'm going to do is enlarge it so that most of it is kind of popping off the screen, and it's really just the one donut that we see at a time. And I'm going to move around so that we start with the pink donut first, and I'm going to use the purple line to give us that guide so that I know that we have the center point of the circle. Then we need to add our text, and for quickness I am just going to select the text on the first page, but I will tell you what all the fonts are. So donut font is called More Sugar, and the strawberry dream text is called Bobby Jones Soft, and on there is called Aileron. Now we need to add this effect here, the buy one get one free, and I'm going to show you how I created that button just now. I'm going to start off just kind of copy this text for quickness, and if I type buy one get one free, then we can capitalize, make uppercase all the letters, and I'm going to make it the bold font as well, and then I'm going to slightly space out the lettering, which just helps when we want to kind of make it that curve shape. Then I'm going to remove the animation. Now when you copy text, look at that, it copies animations, so don't want to have any animation on that text, but I do want to add an effect, which is the curve. So I'm going to add the curve just now, and I'm going to need that curve to be more or less the 100%, but I want to leave a wee bit of a gap between the words, so it just sits at 94, and as you can see, we still have the wee gap here. Then we want to add that donut shape, so back up to elements, donut shape. Oh, I forgot the H, can't spell. And this time I want the solid shape, but this one I feel the hole is a little too big, but I like this one better. And again, what's really good is I can change the color to get it to match my design exactly. I'm going to pick that orange so that it stands out. And then when we copy this across, we want to enlarge the text so it fits nicely within the circle, like so. And then I'm going to change the text to white, and I'm just going to increase that spacing a wee bit more. Again, we can go back in and edit that so that it gives us that same gap. Right, I'm quite happy with that. And when I'm happy with that, again, I'm going to hold down my shift key and select the text and the donut circle and group so that it's just the one element. And then you can see when I increase and decrease the size of that circle, the text automatically resizes as well. And then we'll just sit that in the front here. And then I did have one more wee element at the bottom, and this was an outline donut, and I'll just select that one there, that's fine. Pop it along the center, and again change the color to the same bright pink that the title is in. So that's all the elements that I had on the first page, and I'm going to reduce the timeline of that down to about 1.5 seconds. And if you're struggling to see the timeline, you can click on the zoom here and you can increase the spacing so that you can kind of see the timeline a bit more clearly. But click on the three dots and we're just going to duplicate that page. And the first thing I'm going to do is change the background color. And you'll notice because our elements overlap, you can easily select the background. And this is where layers is brilliant. So go back up to position and go to layers. And now I can select the background and I can change the color. And I'm going to change it to the light lilac-y color, because the next donut that we could see is the purple one, and then a slightly darker shade for the grainy texture. And I'm just going to check what I called it. I called it a violet surprise. So if we change our text to violet surprise and change the colour of the text to that dark purple, and change the colour of the donut to the dark purple, get the motion animation effect to work. What we now need to do is rotate the donuts 90 degrees. So we have the purple donut, and we also need to rotate the buy one get one free clockwise 90 degrees. And again, we're just going to rotate it till the degree hits 90, and then we go down to between our two slides and add an animation called Match and Move. And you can see how that has now rotated the donuts in the circle, and it's a little quick, so I'm just going to move it up to 0.7 to try and slow that down a little. So now if I play this, you can see that we get that lovely motion animation. Now we want to duplicate that page again, and we're going to do the same steps again. This time we are going to rotate this round another 90 degrees, and we now have the light blue donut. And again, we need to go to position and layers and change the background color. And we'll go for light blue this time and a slightly darker color for the gradient. And I'm just going to check what I called that bubblegum. Change the text and make it the dark turquoise. And again, we also need to rotate the buy one get one free this time to 180, so it moves another 90 degrees. And then we'll add in the transition again. We'll choose match and move and make it 0.7. And then we need to do one more transition because we have four. So it's the same steps again, duplicate page. And we've got the lemon donut this time. So I think we'll choose a nice yellow background. And I don't have one here, but what we can do is if I choose this yellow, it's far too dark. But if I scroll back up and I click the plus sign, what we can do is just select a yellow that's a bit further along the top line, so it's a bit of a paler, more pastel yellow. And then again, when we select yellow here, you can see it's a bit bright. I'm going to go back up to my color wheel and select one that's maybe not quite so dense in color. We need to move our color wheel round 90 degrees. There we go. And also change buy one get one free 90. Now another way you can do the rotation is you can go up to position and you can go to arrange, and then with this one here and rotate, you can type in the exact value you want it to be as well. So there's two different ways we can add the rotation. And lastly, let's call this lemon green and we'll change the color. We'll make this an orange just so it stands out against the yellow. There we go there. And then lastly, add the transition, match and move, and we're going to make it the same as the others, 0.7. and now when I play it from that fourth page where we started building this, if I play it just now, you can see that we have the rotations for each transition and also the colors changing as well. So I hope you enjoyed that tutorial, and I will be uploading lots more. I've also added this template directly to the Canva library. Follow my Canva creator profile to access all my templates. If you found this video useful, then do make sure to like, comment, and I would love you to subscribe. I am growing my channel, and please keep watching for the next video if you would love to see more Canva tips and tricks, because I'm your designer in your pocket, helping you create kick-ass graphics even if you're not a pro.